As for the cowardly, being a coward is a sin in the kingdom.
The faithless.
The faithless. God have mercy on us.
The detestable.
Detestable.
Detestable, yes.
Yes, the detestable. What does that mean?
Maybe you can read step by step, then I can pick that word.
Hallelujah.
But as for the cowardly, the faithless, the detestable, as for, here it's abominable.
Abominable. Detestable. When you detest something, it means you don't like something. Detestable. Things that are not, that God does not want. There are certain things that God does not want to be done. So you do them, or you use them. Like in the Old Testament, there was this issue of passing your children in fire. God always told the children of Israel never to do it, but people would do it. That's an abomination. It's detestable.
As for murderers.
Murderers.
The sexual immoral.
Sexually immoral. Sexually immoral, you see. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9, where we read, it was very specific. Fornicators. Having sex before marriage. Adulterers having sex outside marriage. But sexually immoral is putting all of them together, including kissing and everything else. Because somebody will say, you see, I just hugged and kissed someone's wife. I didn't sleep with them. So I will enter heaven. Then you go around, you know, touching people and doing all manner of things. Let's tell each other the truth. This is a kingdom. Amen. Sexually immoral. Anything that is sexual. Remember your king. Sees even in your mind. She's talking of masturbation as part of it. In fact, somebody sent me a message the other day. He needed help. He said, "Pastor, help me. I started masturbation. That is playing with their private parts as if they are having sex. And the problem with masturbation is you have to do imaginations. It's very dirty, praise the Lord. So, in fact, I have heard a number of people saying that, but his was worse. So he says, when he masturbates, he actually hears the voice of someone screaming. He actually hears someone screaming. So it's like as he's masturbating, he's actually having sex with a spirit wife. So somebody who is doing masturbation, they are attracting spirit husbands, they are attracting spirit wives. Another person was in prison, and there was a photo of a beautiful woman hanging on the wall. And this guy was, when he is masturbating, will look at that photo. And he will hear that woman screaming, enjoying with him. And then you get addicted and those demons get hold of you. It's something somebody has to break away. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And some people say, no, I think when you are married now, you will be safe. Let me tell you, I used to do it. That's why I'm explaining. I'm telling you what I used to do. I used to masturbate. Yes, you have never heard it. I see one of my children looking at me. I have to tell you the truth. It's horrible. You do it, and it can get so bad that you, per day, I don't know how many times. Everybody in here, you are very innocent. Your faces, you have never seen this kind of thing. You are even wondering what I'm talking about. I'm the only one who has sinned. Praise the Lord. You finish like this, you want to go somewhere, just feel like, let me do again. Let me do again. Until your body is very tired and painful. And you're like, ah, God, have mercy on me. Let me leave this thing. And then people think when you get married, it gets finished. It doesn't. You know who helped me to get delivered? It was my wife. I told my wife, there is something I need to confess. What is it? I said, I do masturbation. He said, huh? Okay, my husband. Then she lectured me and prayed with me from there. Years after years, years after years, I'm free. You have to tell someone. There are things that don't just go. I told you how I got hooked up into pornography several years ago. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Am I still saying something that helps anybody? Mm. Or you just want fire? The Lord is raising you. I see in the name of Jesus. Power, power. People are dying in sin. They are bound by sin. But when you meet them, they look holy and sanctimonious. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I entered into pornography nicely. Holily. If there is such a word. I did not ask for it. I just said, you see, I'm a father and I'm a preacher. So I need to know. That time I was not yet a pastor, but I was a preacher for years. So I need to understand this pornography thing that people talk about. So that when I'm telling my own children, you know, I will be able to. Why? You look like this. Those people are devilish. That's why majority of them have tattoos and all kinds of things. You look like this, you say, oh, Jesus, Holy Spirit, can you see this? This is horrible. That's why I'm saying I did it holily. I was engaging God in the process. Lord, this is not, this is bad. And I removed it. Ha! Another time, I get into the computer room at work. I find somebody has been watching that thing, those things. He tried to remove those videos. I mean, videos that are good, videos of God. When somebody has been watching them, they want to remove them. They remove them nicely. But those ones of Kingdom of Darkness, somebody was watching them and he failed to switch. He tried to switch off the computer was refusing. I get there, I find the video is still on. I'm like, I thought I was the only one who watched this thing last time. Can you imagine? Devil, I curse you right now. Then I fight with the computer, but as I'm fighting with the computer, it's there, I'm watching. The only way to cut the long story short, I had to talk to my baby, my wife. My wife has been very helpful. Thank you, mommy. Yeah. We have to tell the truth. I told her, honey, there is something I watched like this, like this. She had never watched it also. Very clean girl. She was very clean. She didn't. I said, now, this thing now is following me everywhere. From that time, I don't care. So what am I saying? Have a friend who loves God. Because my wife is my best friend. Have a friend who loves God. Whom you can say, hey, look, this thing is attacking me. Praise the name of Jesus. And let me tell you something that I saw that time when I watched pornography. There was some videos were being suggested to me. I will not mention the name of one great minister of the gospel. This is evangelist so-and-so's favorite site. So you think you are safe when you are looking through those things. They know you. So imagine if I was still doing it right now. There can be some members who meet me there. And I think I don't know, but we are together. Then I'm in church now, I'm saying acceptable behavior in the kingdom. And somebody saying, useless man, we meet you in the sights. There is nothing safe. You are not safe when you do sin. I've realized it's so sweet to love to live a clean life. It's sweet. There are things, even on Facebook these days, I just see somebody who likes to post nude pictures. I remove them as a friend. That's the way to deal with it. So prevention is better than cure. Don't even allow. And then even where you work, let people know that you are truly born again. When they are talking funny language, they will say, Wilbert is here. How can we be talking these things? Praise the Lord. But some people are born again and they even preach, they sing in the choir. Yet things can be talked about that are horrible and they will be included and they will be laughing and encouraging bad language. May the Lord deliver us. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So we were on Revelation 21 verse 8. The detestable, sexually immoral. What else? Murderers, whoremongers, sorcerers, idolaters, all liars. Do we have liars in the house? All of you tell the truth, right? You are safe. Liars will not enter the kingdom of God. You don't belong there. Tell the truth. Tell your neighbor, I tell the truth all the time. So help me God. Ooh, may God have mercy on us. Acceptable behavior in the kingdom. The reason why, if you talk to my spiritual parents who brought me to Christ, they will tell you this. This is me. Even when I gave my life to Christ, I was telling people every evil I ever did. I remember the man who brought me to Christ was saying, isn't it enough? I think you people have hurt you and God has forgiven you. I think now you can stop talking about it. I wanted everybody to understand that it's not acceptable to be in God and living the same way that I used to live. So, like I mentioned, the things I'm mentioning about myself, and these audios will be listened to by people all over the world who follow me. You can imagine some people will say, he's still doing it, he's a liar. It's okay, but I'm saying it to help others who want to be helped. There are those who don't want to be helped. They will criticize. It's okay. Let's meet in heaven. If you criticize when we are telling you the truth and we are giving you examples of what we used to do, so that you can come out, so that you can pray and fast and fight, so that you are completely out of this. Do you know there are preachers who drink beer before going on the pulpit for confidence sake? There are preachers who take drugs to preach. I will not give examples. Take drugs. When they stand in front like this, they will be screaming and they are like, wow. God is watching you. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. Now let's go to Exodus chapter. Let's go to Matthew chapter 22. Somebody being blessed. Amen. Acceptable behavior in the kingdom. So in the kingdom, there are commandments. Maybe in your country, you see, a country, but you will also see that the laws of every country, they don't differ much from the Bible. In many instances, there are things that are not allowed in the society, and the Bible also doesn't allow them. But you really need to understand what the kingdom laws say. God gave commandments to Moses. Amen? One of the tablets broke, and God said, no, 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 we need to write another tablet. That's how serious God was. The king said, we will write afresh. And here you are thinking, you know, God is a God of mercy. The only thing you know about King God is mercy. Show me one king in this world who is merciful only. Nothing else about them. You step on their toe, they just smile. Mercy. Show me one president. Show me one of your friends. Mercy. Only mercy. You slap them on the cheek. They just give you another cheek. Show me one. You think God is a fool? He creates the whole world. He gives you free oxygen. He gives you free sunshine. He gives you free rain. He gives you free many things. He gives you free life. After that, you say, he's a God of mercy. Only mercy is the thing you know because you are defending yourself. Do not be deceived. Do not be deceived. You cannot live in the kingdom of God the same way you were doing in the devil's kingdom. Hallelujah. Tell the truth. Live a godly life. Hallelujah. Matthew 22, verse 37 to 40.